So in this video presentation, we're going to look at adding an intermediate switch to our circuit. Our original circuit consisted of a two-way switch and a two-way switch controlling a lighting point. And now we've added in an intermediate switch to give us three positions of which we can turn on and off the lighting point. So we're going to look at how we're going to wire that up and the connections in the back of the intermediate switch in this presentation. As discussed in the previous presentations, as we're wiring in PVC singles, we have the ability to take our conductors exactly where we need them to go. So let's start with the blue neutral. We're going to take out the neutral bar in the consumer's unit and take it directly to the straight skirted batten lamp holder, where we don't matter where we connect it, as we've discussed before, as it has a bayonet cap lamp going into it. So it's a bayonet cap lamp holder, and it won't matter which side we connect our neutral and which side we connect our switching line conductor. So from the consumer unit, the blue neutral goes directly to the lighting point itself. The CPC in the consumer's unit, connected here in the earth bar, green and yellow conductor, leaves there and goes directly to switching point number one, which is a two-way switch. We've connected it into a inshore maintenance-free connector, and we know Wago make the same style design. The CPC then goes to the middle switch, which is our intermediate switch, and again is connected into a maintenance-free connector. From this switch, we've gone to our final switch, which is our two-way switch, and again connected it into a maintenance-free connector. And then our CPC goes up to our straight-skirted batten lamp holder and is terminated into the back connection. We took that route for our CPCs because we wanted to limit the number of CPCs actually at our lighting point itself. So we've gone consumer unit to two-way switch, from two-way switch to intermediate switch, from intermediate switch to the final two-way switch, and then we've taken our CPC up to our straight-skirted batten lamp holder. Fully insulated system, plastic conduit and plastic switches and boxes. So CPC, as we've discussed previously, is there in case we change it for an exposed conductive part. In other words, we fit a metallic light switch or a metallic box onto the lighting circuit itself. The line connection starts at the 6-amp circuit breaker, and our line connection, similar to what we did in two-way, our line connection comes from the consumer's unit and goes directly into the common of the switch, the first switch being a two-way switch. Again, remember we said it could be either way up, I've just shown it this way around, so it goes straight into the common. So the line connection from the circuit breaker goes into the common of the first two-way switch. Two strappers from L1 and L2 come out, across and down into our intermediate switch. Sometimes there's some mild confusion with my learners because the two strappers from the intermediate, to the intermediate switch from this two-way switch either go in the top two connections or the bottom two connections, but not across the side. However, the drawing hopefully that appears here now does show those two strappers come in, and it looks like they're going in the side. The reason being, the drawing, hopefully which is shown here, shows the switch actually rotated into that position to make it an easier wiring diagram to look at. So when I turn over my switch, I've got the two connections running in here, two strappers, and two strappers running out there. So it is correct from the point of view that we would have to rotate that switch round. Two strappers from the first two-way switch either go in the top two terminations or into the bottom two terminations, but not across the side. We'll make that a little bit clearer in the classroom as well. So just to recap them, line goes straight into common. The first set of strappers from L1 and L2 come out, down, and into either the top two connections of our intermediate switch or the bottom two. Doesn't matter which way round they are, as long as they go from L1 and L2 into either the top set or the bottom set. Then another set of strappers, either from the top set or the bottom set, come out, round and down, and are connected into L1 and L2 of our second two-way switch. And then from common, as before, from common we come up to a lighting point and connect it next to the neutral straight skirted bayonet cap lamp holder in order to have control. So let's recap. The line conductor starts at the top of the 6-amp breaker, goes down to the first two-way switch, it's connected in common. Two strappers come out from the two-way switch, down to the intermediate switch, and are either connected in the top two or the bottom two terminals. Two more strappers come out of the intermediate switch, top two or bottom two terminals, come out, down, and into our final two-way switch, where they're connected in L1 and L2. From common, we go back to the lighting point itself in order to turn it on. We can have as many intermediate switches as we like, as long as we've got a two-way and a two-way switch positioned. So as many of these as we like, breaking those strappers. Again, we'll discuss that in the classroom.